What's going on, guys? So today we're talking about the Artisan Cutlery Sea Snake. Now this is a neck knife that I've had for a couple months now. This is actually one of the prototypes from Artisan Cutlery. I was originally contacted by Mike, the designer of this knife, and asked me if I wanted to check it out. He's pretty excited about it and everything. I said, yeah, sure. And he was nice enough to send one out for me to test. And that's this one. And first thing I did was I threw on this bead necklace and I carried it as a neck knife, all right? Obviously, with the holes in the sheath, you can do whatever you want. You can carry this, you know, belt style, you can put a clip on it, whatever floats your boat. But you know me, I love my neck knives. As far as a neck knife, the first thing that I did notice is it carries very well, but it does spin only because of the sheath style. There's one hole on top. Obviously, when you have two holes, it kind of stays steady. With one hole, it tends to, you know, rotate around a little bit. Not the end of the world, but definitely worth noting if you decided to carry this as a neck knife as well. Now, one thing I really do like about the sheath, though, is that it's a fold-over design, so it's very minimal. Okay, there's not a lot of wasted kydex or a big form there. So, more importantly than the sheath is the knife itself. This is a really cool knife. I really like this. Artisan Cutlery is one of those companies that I have kind of limited experience with. I have a couple of their knives, but I didn't get a whole lot of use out of them since I've had them. This particular design I really like, though. It is kind of small. Like, I mean, for a neck knife, it may not be super small to you, but overall, it's a smaller knife. 3.1 inches on our blade, which is that nice Wharncliffe. This one is an ARRPM9, okay? I kind of giggled there before I said that because it's hard to remember because it's brand new. It's a proprietary steel that is specific to Artisan. In fact, there was a whole bunch of secrecy in the beginning as to what it was, you know, composed of. The actual composition was like a secret, right? Trying to get patents on it. I think it's really cool that they're doing different things and obviously trying to create new different blade steels and stuff. I really put this thing through the ringer, okay? I cut a ton of stuff with this, and I have to say it's pretty impressive. Overall, this knife sells for $53. As of right now, it's only available through Artisan directly. I have to assume at some point they're going to ship them to dealers, and it'll be available at all your favorite dealers and stuff. But right now, you can only buy it direct, but $53 is not all that bad. There's also currently a coupon code. It's Artisan021. And that knocks off 5%, so, you know, goes towards shipping, or, you know, you consider it a $50 knife in that respect. Now, the design is really nice. I mean, it's very comfortable. You can choke up here, okay, or you can hang back. There's a nice finger choil, but it's kind of an even finger choil size to that blade choil, okay, so you could really get up high on that if you wanted to. There is jimping on the back, okay, so in either position, your thumb does actually facilitate a fair amount of grip there. A fairly slim handle scales. This does come in a couple different colors. This one is the kind of OD green type coloration. I really like the handle scales because they're very rounded. It just overall feels slim and round and super comfortable. Okay, you can see by design the handle scales are just slightly shorter than the actual stock on that knife, which is not a big deal. Usually this bums me out. So many different companies do this, and then what happens is you don't feel the scales, you just feel the actual frame. Okay, obviously it's full tang, which everyone wants and loves, but when you have this design, sometimes it's uncomfortable because of that. This, I have no problems at all. So even though it's poking out a little bit all the way around, no issues with comfort. I can definitely feel those scales, and again, being so rounded and stuff, they're just super, super comfortable. So on the front, we just have the Artisan Cutlery logo there. All right, on the back, we see a serial number. In this case, it's 1842, and you can see the ME design. It's, of course, for the creator of the knife. This is produced in China, you can see down here, and again, our ARRPM9. Now, this blade steel, again, originally was a proprietary steel, and it was like very hush-hush, very secretive, right? But eventually, the composition was talked about and put out there online. I think I originally saw it on Blade Forums. So, for the people who care and the people who know and understand this, the carbon content is 0.9%. The chromium is 18%, which is very, very high. The molybdenum is 1%. The manganese is 0.45%. It's 0.1% vanadium, 0.3% cobalt, 0.2 to 0.8% silicone, and less than 0.4% nickel. So, you know, for a lot of people, that's not going to matter. You have no idea what that means. But some people who are like super obsessed with blade steels, you know exactly what that means. Yeah, I've seen people compare this to all different types of things. The best way I can really describe it is like the best 440C you're ever going to have. Okay. Almost as it, like, I don't know actually if there's a powdered version of 440C, but I have to assume that would be the closest comparison, at least from my experience. I haven't used every steel in the book, you know, and I'm not like a super expert on all the steel compositions and all that kind of stuff. I just, you know, take my knives and I use them. What I can tell you from experience is that this has fantastic edge holding capability, even though it's a softer steel. Now, I haven't had any issues at all with rolling or chipping or anything, but because it's softer, I have to assume that it would probably roll before it would chip. But the one thing I did notice is that this drops up really, really easy, okay? It held an edge fairly well, like I said. I mean, it's not going to completely blow you away, but as far as the $50 price tag goes, being, you know, a cheaper steel, it's not really, like, considered a cheap steel, okay? This is not, like, bottom-of-the-barrel stuff, but it's nowhere near premium either. I would say that this is a very, very good working steel, all right? But the fact that it does strop up for the people who are smart enough out there to strop your knives, because if you're not stropping, you're missing out. And I talked about this before, but if you're kind of newer to knives, you know, you have a knife, it's sharp, you use the knife, it gets dull, right? What you're doing is you're rubbing away that edge and it's getting fatter and fatter and wider, so it doesn't want to cut through things. It doesn't want to, you know, separate material. That's what you do when you're cutting, you're separating material. So instead of having to sharpen all the time, if you strop your knife edge, what you're doing is you're maintaining that sharp edge, okay? You're prolonging the amount of time in between sharpenings, okay? So regardless of steel type, I can definitely take a knife and it will stay sharper much longer by just, you know, a couple passes on a strop. It really takes no time at all. So as an aside from this knife, I really, really recommend stropping in general. Doesn't matter what knife you use, what kind of steel, what price tag, stropping is the way to go. It really will keep your knife nice and sharp as long as possible. Eventually you will have to sharpen it, but anyway. So yes, as far as this specific knife design goes, I really like it. I think it's really cool. I love everything about this. I, again, wish the sheath had just that double hole on top, but I because it's kind of a real low profile sheath, I totally understand it. If I had my own rivet gun, which maybe eventually I'll get, I'd love to just pop another rivet in here, although I don't know if there's enough meat left in that sheath to get maybe a smaller rivet. But, you know, again, it's all, the only thing I'm really complaining about, I'm not really complaining, is the fact that this does this. It, you know, it spins and turns because there's only one point where this is hanging from. But that is a very, very small, I guess, complaint. But yeah, I mean, you know, it's super comfortable to use. Most times when I was using this, I was not actually choking up on it, okay? I would pull it from the sheath and, you know, in the sheath position here, I was already in that cutting position. I just didn't find myself like actually choking up, except for specific cutting around the house and things, you know? Doing kind of like this little pinch grip, it works out totally fine. Because there's a large blade choil, I have chunky hands, chunky fingers, okay? I'm overweight. I'm not the only one, all right? So don't make fun of me. But yeah, even with my chunky finger, I can get a lot of that meat on there without actually cutting myself. There's plenty of cool knives on the market that have small blade choils and you go to choke up. And for me personally, I have to use the tip of my finger because if I use my whole finger like that, I'm obviously rubbing on the edge and I could cut myself. You know what I mean? So I do definitely appreciate the larger blade choil in this design. Essentially, we just have a short run. The whole blade, I think, is 3.1 inches, but a short run of cutting edge that's completely flat. There's no belly here at all. There is a nice fine point though, so I was able to, you know, easily pierce into boxes and stuff before ripping them open. Total length is 6.7 inches, and that's about it. There's not much else to say. I mean, as far as the steel, again, just having one example of it, I was pretty impressed. I'd love to try this again in the future. I'd love to maybe try some different artisan cutlery knives down the road. I'm assuming that they're going to use this steel in a ton of different models because it is their own, you know, deal. So keep an eye out for that. ARRPM9. Pretty interesting stuff. I would definitely say it is kind of middle ground. You know, it performs fairly well for the price. I would say it performs great for its price range, but it's not going to compete with all the top stuff. It's still, you know, on the softer side of things. But, you know, blade steel comes down to preference. Some people really like super hard steels. Obviously, they have that amazing edge retention. Just stay sharp forever. But you know what? Depending on what you're doing with your knives, that could be a bad thing. You could be chipping them out. You could be overusing them on different, you know, cutting tasks where you want something cheap. You know, you want something that's going to be a little bit softer. So it kind of comes down to preference, you know. But at the end of the day, as far as a middle ground or cheaper steel, it does have pretty good edge retention. I don't have rust issues on pretty much any of my knives, unless it's like summer and I'm really sweating and I put it away wet, which I really rarely ever do. I take care of my knives, believe it or not. So as far as like, you know, it's corrosion resistance, I couldn't tell you. I'd have to purposely cut, you know, some acidic things or, you know, different things that might want to eat into that metal. So I can't refer to that at all, you know, from my kind of experience and stuff, but the edge holding capability is pretty nice. So yeah, I mean, thanks to Mike. I mean, I really, really appreciate it. It's very nice of you to send this and, you know, let me check it out. I think it's a really cool design. I think these are gonna be really popular. Hopefully they end up at dealers as well. I know, you know, some people just don't like ordering direct. I mean, $53, I can't imagine what these are gonna sell for. If Artisan's selling for 53 direct, I have to assume these are gonna be like $40, $38 to $40 maybe. That's a total guess as to what dealers would sell. I mean, obviously they're buying them in bulk and selling them, you know, a little bit cheaper than MSRP. I don't know if $53 is the MSRP, but I'm assuming because they're being purchased direct that it is. So I don't know, time will tell, we'll see. But right now, if you happen to be interested, you can only get them direct. But at least the coupon code helps a little bit with the shipping. Or like I said, it's more like a $50 knife instead of a $53 knife. So that's all for now. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you do eventually get one of these, come back to this video and comment. Let people know what you thought of it. But overall, it's pretty impressive. I mean, I love, you know, budget knives. I use quotes there because everyone has a different opinion on what a budget knife is. Some people's budget knife is your $4 Ozark trail knife. Which, by the way, I have some Christmas videos coming. I have to get down to Wally World at some point, see what they're offering for those Christmas specials. But other people's budget knife is a $200 Benchmade or Spyderco or something, just because they're so used to using really, really expensive knives. So they beat on their $200 beater. But I would say in the $50 range, that's pretty budget friendly. I think most people can probably swing a knife up to $100. You know, if it's something that they're really investing in and going to carry all the time and stuff. So it's in that range. And I think it's a pretty good choice. So, but again, I mean, not everyone likes not everyone likes neck knife carry. Okay, so even though I carry this as a neck knife, it'd be a cool little belt knife or something, especially if you want to carry it scout style. It's nice and small and compact and stuff, so I don't think it'd be, you know, too uncomfortable to carry. But who knows? People like to carry knives all different ways. Maybe this would make an interesting little boot knife. But anyway, that's it for now. That is the Artisan Cutlery Sea Snake. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope you have a wonderful day. And I will see you tomorrow with, you guessed it, another video. I've been posting them every day for like 12 years now. So if you're missing them, come back every single day if you want to see them, because it'll be a new one. Anyway, hope you guys have a good one. See you tomorrow.